What's going on, guys? It's Leo from Jungle Lacrosse here today with a first impressions and kind of a review for you. I'm sorry, I'll apologize. I'm pretty sick right now, but on to what it is. So if you follow me on Instagram, and if you don't, my Instagram is jungle_lacrosse. Please give me a follow. I'm almost to 1,000 followers. It's crazy. Just about a year ago, a little over a year ago, I started this account. And anyway, now on to this. If you follow me, and you would know that I'm excited. I have been excited for String King's release of Grizzly Mesh for a while. String King's release of Grizzly Mesh. I've been extremely excited for it. Could not wait for it. And they released it on Friday at like 9:18. I remember looking at the time, so I was like, I wonder what time zone they're in. And I was pretty sure they were over in East Coast. And they just released it like 20 minutes late. Like, I guess I thought it was going to be released at midnight. It was, so over there it was like 12 to 1. Anyway, I got it, and I just got one piece to start out with because I wanted to make sure that I liked it. And obviously, you guys just saw this absolutely monstrous bag here. Crazy. I've never even gotten like that deep before in with a wax mesh. I kind of used their pocket. The channel on it is not great. That's where you're getting it. It's a little wider, but it's nice. It's extremely deep. It's extremely valuable. I'm going to use it in practice tonight and in my game on Monday. But first impressions, so I'm going to tell you guys, it's $40. And there was a lot of talk about when Epic did their otter mesh, and it hit $40. This is a little bit more reasonable, saying that it's a goalie mesh and not a player mesh. I also picked up a piece of otter mesh and a piece of type 2S when I got it, and some shooters and stuff. And then I got a 20% off discount. So it came out to $85 rather than like $105. So it's quite a bit taken off. But yeah, on with the mesh. $40. Immediately I'm going to tell you it's worth it. It's amazing. I was looking at their website, looking at some statistics for it. And basically, the one thing that always gets you is weight. Honestly, when I was looking at the weight of this is 83 grams, just the mesh, and, the weight of a regular 12 diamond hard mesh, a standard 12 diamond hard mesh, the average, they said was 117 grams, so that's, 54 grams taken off, and then the average, I think that's 54, I might be wrong, correct me if I'm wrong, but, also, the standard average wax mesh was 119 grams, so this is 55 grams less. So that's quite a bit. It's enough to make a difference, honestly. I think that's why I got it. And I used to use throne mesh, and I don't know. I might make the switch, I might not. Depends on how much I like it. Pricing is obviously less for throne mesh, but I'm willing to spend the extra money if it's something that's gonna make me play better. So, first off, a string ability. A lot of people were thinking, how is this thing gonna, how is it, shape retention, is it gonna, how is that gonna do? And honestly, amazing. They added this thing, I'm pretty sure they were talking about it, it's called resin or resign. And basically what it is it's something that adds no weight, you can't feel it, you can't smell it, you can't like touch it, and it basically acts as the wax when it makes it the pocket for. So it's got very nice shape retention for a string king, or actually anything other than a wax mesh. I would say it's just a little bit less than a wax mesh, but honestly great. One thing that I did notice is it seemed a little, diamonds seem a little bit bigger than a standard 12 diamond wax mesh. So, and I like that. It helps maintain the deeper pocket and everything. Also, is so onto waterproof, because overall this is Riley from High Strung Lacrosse will say it's waterproof. It's not water resistant as other wax meshes are, because it is a mesh and it's gonna stay. It's gonna be a constant waterproofness throughout the entire life of the mesh. So obviously, 10 out of 10. Everybody was expecting that. We all knew that that was gonna be waterproof. So that's no surprise. Next thing that was kind of a surprise was the weatherproofness. After that, after the water, I dried it off a bit with a towel and then stuck it in my freezer for 15 minutes, took it out, and it got harder. So, basically what this is any water that ended up being on top of it at all, when it was in there for the 15 minutes, was frozen, and so, it was ice. So it actually got harder, but after a few seconds taking it out, it was fine. The only thing that could be bad is you might be in a state, in a game where the first half of the game is raining, the second half of the game it starts to snow, and yeah, say that happens and your mesh gets harder because it starts to get frozen. But when you compare that to a wax mesh, the wax mesh is going to get harder probably 3 to 4 times as fast because of the wax. So this is the better bet on that. So on weatherproofness, I would give it a 9 out of 10, because overall, everything else, it was pretty nice. I played around with it a little bit, and it's not super dirty. I was playing around pretty much dirt, too, so that's, I guess that's good. It stayed pretty nice, pretty clean. I haven't put it through any mud or anything. I'll use it on turf tonight, and I'm going to be having a second video of the overall everything of it in probably a couple of weeks, once I have a few games with it, see the consistency, see if it bags out at all, you know, the main things. But I think it's all gonna be pretty much the same. And yeah, so you're able to get a really nice pocket with it, as you can see, as long as you're using the right pattern and stuff. There's gonna be no you're not gonna suffer anything changing from a wax mesh to this. The only thing is maybe some loss of whip, because say, I'll just throw out the name East Coast Mesh, they're tackier, so the ball's gonna stick to the mesh a little bit more, and this has absolutely no wax on it at all, so it's not gonna stick at all to this, and you might have to change your pattern up a little bit. And sorry, I just got a text. And so that's pretty much it for right now, guys. Honestly, it's worth the buy. Go get some. I'm over this weekend, I'm gonna be getting probably 2 to 3 more pieces. Probably 2 more pieces. I might get some more shrinking mesh, might get some more, a little more everything, pretty much. So, that's pretty much it for right now. Also, I forgot to say it, both of my pre-strungs on my website have been marked down $10 less. So the Rabel 2X was $95 and it is now $85. Hop on that, guys. It's got free shipping and everything. I really need it gone. Also, my brand new RP3, which is right up there, you guys probably can't even see it, but yeah, that was marked down from $115 to $105 free shipping. So hop on that before anyone else buys that, guys. Really need to move this inventory. Also, my STX Eclipse, that was up for sale a while ago. I took it down because I realized, like, oh, it's my first head, I should probably keep it. Literally 1 week after, my coach came up to me and said, hey, do you have any goalie heads for sale? Right after I gave away my old Nemi, and so he said it was going for his under-9 youth team that he's starting, and I said, yeah, I do. So I'm going to sell it to him for a nice price. I think it's going to be about $35. It's going to be strung with the old throne mesh that wasn't here. And honestly, I like it because it's going to a good cause, you know. It's going to younger kids learning, and I'm going to be helping out with that for many service hours. So that is the end of this video. Like this video if you liked it. Follow me on Instagram. My Instagram is at jungle_lacrosse, as I already said. Subscribe if you haven't, and have a great day, guys.